Hello my dear friends and welcome to StudyIQ. I am Joycey Joy and today in this lecture we will discuss about Africa's booming population and we will also see that how the booming population in Africa is a challenge for Africa. Now if you look the case of India, China, etc. These are all populous countries. So it all depends on whether a government or whether a country is able to reap the benefits of population or due to its weak governance or problems, they are further moving towards underdevelopment. So here in this lecture, we will discuss about the case of Africa and what are the population trends in Africa in different countries. And we will also see how it is a challenge for Africa. So let us start. But before that, this is our channel StudyIQ and we are providing pen drive courses for various competitive examinations including SSC and bank courses, UPSC optionals, SSC JE courses, teaching examination, railway examination, defense examination, RBI grade B, NABARD grade A, UGC NET, UPSC Civil Services Examination, CLAT exams for various state PSCs and also for various professional courses. You can visit our website www.studyiq.com for more details or you can call to any of these numbers for more information. So let us start. Let us first understand what is the status of population in Africa. Now, if you look at the trend of population growth in Africa, in the sub-Saharan Africa, the population has almost doubled in the last 3 decades and it is expected to triple by the end of this century. So in the past 3 decades, in the last 30 years, the population in sub-Saharan Africa has almost doubled and by the end of this century, it is expected to triple. That is multiply 3 times. So this is in contrast to world's developed economies. So in case of world's developed economies, we see a decline in the fertility or there is a reduction or decline in the population in most of the developing countries. So the case of sub-Saharan Africa is almost the contrast to what is happening in the developed countries. Now, coming to the population scenario. So the growing number of young or working age people creates economic opportunities for a country. It creates more space for economic growth and development because when more people engage in productive activities, when more people engage in economic activities, the output generated will be more. So it directly correlates to the GDP of a country. So output increases means the GDP increases and this should contribute towards growth and development of a country. But there is a condition. So there is growing number of young people or working age people, there should be creation of economic opportunities. So if there is an absence of economic opportunities for these people to realize their potential, this growing population can in turn become a challenge. So it all depends on how the governments will manage the population boom and what strategy it will adopt in order to create economic opportunities. Now if we take the case of India, the Indian government has adopted a path of shifting to manufacturing or various initiatives like Make in India, MSME sector improvement, all these were created in order to support the booming population, in order to support the working age population and in order to utilize the benefits of the demographic dividend. So it is not sure whether the governments in Africa will be able to do the same as the developed countries in their past had done and whether they will be able to benefit out of the opportunities of a demographic dividend. Now let us understand about the population surge in Africa and why there was a population surge in Africa. There are various factors that have contributed towards this population surge. The first and the primary reason would be better medical care. So you know that when a population receives better medical care, it will lead to increased life expectancy and decreased mortality rates. So increased life expectancy plus decreased mortality rates will increase the rate of population or the population growth. Now if we take the life expectancy or the average life expectancy of people in sub-Saharan Africa, since 2000 there was a great improvement. So in 2000 it was 50, now it has increased to 61. So the life expectancy has increased because of better medical care facilities that are available. Now if we take an individual example of that of Nigeria alone, it is predicted that Nigeria will double its population to 400 million people by the middle of the century, and this will make Nigeria the world's third most populous country after China and India. So one reason is better medical care facilities. Now another reason is increased per capita GDP. So GDP is basically the final value of all the final goods and services produced in an economy during a financial year. So per capita GDP is the GDP of a country divided by its population. So the sub-Saharan Africa's per capita GDP has climbed 40% since the start of this century. The reason is the availability of resources in the continent, for example the oil reserves, other natural resources, minerals, etc. But even though we understand that there are surplus of mineral reserves or oil reserves and other valuable resources available in the country, there is also another fact that even when some countries in Africa are very rich or wealthier in terms of its resource availability, there are some other countries in the same continent which are very poor countries, very much underdeveloped countries. For example, those countries where there is prevalence of great or high levels of poverty, unemployment, mortality rates, etc. So these are some of the factors that has contributed towards a surge in the population in Africa. Now we will understand how can Africa benefit from this. Now, if you look into the population of Africa, sub-Saharan Africa, almost 60% of the population are younger than 25 years. Now, in case of United States, which is considered to be a developed country, it's only 1/3 of its population that are younger than 25. So, this 60% of population who are young population can be translated into workforce, and for that skill, education, healthcare facilities, etc. very important. So sub-Saharan Africa will be able to create a demographic dividend if it's able to provide skills, education, healthcare facilities and other human resource building factors to the population. And along with that, there should also be government intervention. So government should invest more in every child. But in case of sub-Saharan Africa, we have seen that there is a huge inequality. Some of the states or countries are very rich in terms of resources, whereas some countries are very poor and very much underdeveloped. Now coming to the biggest challenge for Africa. For Africa, the biggest challenge would be to create jobs. According to the Asian Development Bank, ADB, it estimates that more than 10 million new jobs should be created each year in order to absorb the number of young people entering the workforce in Africa. So creating 10 million jobs every year would be a challenge for Africa. Now, if you look into the manufacturing sector has already been captured by the automation technology, technological transformation. So in the traditional manufacturing, there was enough opportunity for more number of employment. But in an automated world or a technologically evolved sector, it would be very difficult to find such a huge number of jobs. Now, other alternative that is available is the services sector. Already many countries have started their call centers and other outsourcing operations in Africa. And other opportunity would be its tourism sector. So these are all some of the sectors that could be easily utilized in order to provide jobs to this growing working age population. Now, what are the changes needed in order to help this demographic dividend? First factor would be providing education. Now, if you look at the educational status of sub-Saharan Africa, almost 1/3 of the children in sub-Saharan Africa do not attend any schooling. It means that around 1/3 of its population are illiterate, and on an average only 4% of its population completes graduation or a university course. So education is one factor that needs a big push in this region. Now along with education, malnutrition is another major factor that has made this region underdeveloped. Almost 1 out of 4 in sub-Saharan African region is malnourished according to United Nations data. So malnutrition is another factor. Next one is subsistence agriculture. Now in order to provide food security to its population, the government must invest in infrastructure, in providing public services, in providing subsidies, etc. And it is not enough that the region will adopt subsistence agriculture, but it should also produce surplus. Now let us understand the population trends and let us also study whether this population growth can be slowed. Now compared to other regions, the progress in controlling the population is very slow in Africa. Now if we take the population trend, women in sub-Saharan Africa almost have on an average 4.8 live births on an average. But in 1970s, it was almost 6.8. Now it is 4.8. So here we will see that there is a growth, slowdown in population growth, but it is a very slow pace. Now if we take the examples of North America or European countries, this slowdown in population growth was almost 3 times than that of Africa. So this can be properly dealt with by family planning, use of contraception, etc. Now how will Africa absorb its people, or what will happen if Africa will not be able to absorb this population? The obvious choice is migration. The overcrowded countries like the Philippines, India, Bangladesh, Indonesia, etc. have seen this phase of migration already. So overpopulation in these countries have resulted in migration of its citizens or its population to other countries in search of job and livelihood. But migration, even it's a challenge, because most of the developed countries are closing the doors for other people. Many of the developed countries, the United States, Italy, they are all adopting an anti-immigration sentiment. So it would be challenging for Africa if the different governments are not able to absorb the population, provide them with skills, health and education, and finally convert them into demographic dividends who will be able to work. And also it is challenging to create more jobs for the working age population. You can find the PDF of this lecture on my Facebook page. You can also follow my Facebook page for more video updates. You can write to me at joycy.studyiq@gmail.com for any of your queries and clarifications.